And I know a lot of you guys have been asking how you can use intermittent fasting. If you're a healthcare professional and you have unpredictable hours, or you work 12-hour shifts, or maybe you work night shifts. Now, I have methods that I help my clients with, but I wanted to bring in someone who's successfully done it themselves and let her tell you exactly what she does, give you the tips and strategies of how you can use the complete intermittent fasting bundle throughout this challenge and just in life, while also having an unpredictable schedule, even one that includes night shifts. So today I brought in Dee, who is a healthcare professional, and she's gone through the complete intermittent fasting bundle. She uses strategies within the programs to make herself feel awesome. And she's going to share some of the hurdles she's gone over, her experiences of using those strategies with her schedule, and what she's done to adjust it to her lifestyle. Now, if you are following the intermittent fasting challenge right now, these are great strategies, especially if you do have a unpredictable schedule. Now I'm going to hand it off to Dee so that she can explain some of the strategies that she's used to make intermittent fasting super easy, super accomplishable, super easy to accomplish, even with a healthcare professional schedule.
Hi, Autumn. Thanks so much for having me. I'm a certified registered nurse anesthetist, and I work 12-hour shifts at the hospital from 7 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. Occasionally, I work night shifts. Most of the time, I work day shifts, but occasionally, I rotate to night. Because I have such a schedule and a routine that works so well for me during the day shift, I try to keep it the same, and I keep it very simple for night shift. So what do? If I wake up at 4:45 in the morning during my day shift, I try to wake up at 4:45 p.m. during the night shift. If I have my keto coffee at 6:30 in the morning at day shift, I try to make sure I have it at 6:30 p.m. on night shift. I try to keep everything as simple as possible and try to keep that 12-hour, you know, a.m. to p.m. exactly the same, because my body knows what to expect and then my body knows what it needs. My eating window was pretty variable only because the surgery schedule is so variable and each day looks so different. Typically, we have lunch at my hospital anywhere between like 11:30 or 1:30 in the afternoon. Whenever I would be offered my lunch break, if I was hungry, I would actually open the window and start to eat then, which was usually around 1 or 1:30 in the afternoon. If I wasn't hungry, if I was offered lunch like much earlier at, you know, say 11:30 in the morning, I would just have my apple cider vinegar sipper and some more water until the next time I got a break. I didn't want to force myself to eat just because I had the window of time, because I feel like that's something I had fallen into prior to intermittent fasting, and I wanted to be the one in control of what I was eating and when based on what my body was telling me. I would break my fast around 1 or 1:30 p.m. because that's when the later lunches were offered, and I would try to time it that I ate as late as possible so I could open my window a little bit later in the day. If my window opens around 1 or 1:30 p.m., I could have my last meal, as long as it finished, by 9 or 9:30. So whenever I finished at the hospital was around 7:30 p.m., and I would come home and either have food that I had already prepared or prepare something pretty quickly, and then start eating around 8 or 8:30 and finish by 9. I've been a huge advocate of meal prepping and preparing things for the week in advance. That way I can come home and have a nutritious meal ready to go without having to think too much about it or try to rustle up ingredients or go to the grocery store, etc. The number one thing I can say is that intermittent fasting helped tremendously with my bloating. I went to bed feeling full, but not over full, and I woke up the next morning without this sort of rock in my stomach, like ugh, like gross feeling where I hadn't digested anything and all the food had just been sitting there. The gas was significantly less, which is wonderful. And I had a lot of increased energy, which I was really surprised about. I had the energy to finish my 12-hour shifts. I had the energy to do a workout after work if I wanted, or to, you know, handle my 4:45 in the morning alarm with no problems. So the added energy was a huge bonus, and I was really excited about that. You know, it's important that we take care of ourselves and do everything we can to optimize our own health so that we can take care of others. And I think that intermittent fasting is one of the best tools to do that. It helps your body perform more efficiently, you have more energy, you can give more to those around you, and you can take better care of yourself. Trust the process, take it slow, prepare yourself for success. Start intermittent fasting with that 12-hour window. So 12 hours of eating and 12 hours of not eating. And then slowly, as you finagle your schedule and learn to work with your body and learn to listen to your body's cues, you can narrow that window down even further. You know, maybe half an hour per day or per every other day, or maybe even an hour every week, and kind of shorten that window until you get into an optimal window. For me, I do 8 hours of eating and I do 16 hours of fasting, but it took some time for me to get to that and took some time for me to listen to my body and see what I actually need. So plan ahead, set yourself up for success. You're gonna do great.
All right, Dee, thank you so much for sharing your information. Something to note that she says often throughout this is that she shifted the whole intermittent fasting process to fit her schedule. There's this common misconception that you should have your window be from 12 to 8 p.m. and that's it. And if you're not following that, then you're not doing intermittent fasting. That is simply just not true. And Dee is a great example of that. So this is exactly what the complete intermittent fasting bundle covers on how to make your intermittent fasting experience fit you and your goals and your lifestyle so that you'll actually be successful. Variables such as exercise or food preferences, or if you have to deal with gut healing or hormone balancing, all of these come into play so that we can create your ideal schedule that will fit your goals. Now, like I mentioned, the challenge is still going on. You can still join. If you want to join hundreds of other AM peeps with the challenge and cut out the confusion of intermittent fasting, make sure that you click the link down below so you can get started and join all of us, including myself, in properly using intermittent fasting so that you can achieve your goals and feel amazing again. Also, guys, if you want to check out Dee's blog, I've linked it down below so you can also check that out. All right, guys, if you love the science-backed information on how you can feel your body right, make sure you subscribe right here. Come out with new videos every Tuesday and Thursday. All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you in my next video.